Hello, my dear students. In this lecture video, I'll be discussing with you the physical meaning of scalar product or dot product. Yeah. Okay. So at this point in time, hopefully you've already learned about vector addition and vector subtraction. So this time we go to the other, let me use blue, other operation, which is multiplication. So we now go to vector products. Yan. So I hope you've read, no? Because it's important that you read our textbook, because I cannot discuss everything in a video. This is only supplementary to everything that you shall have been reading. So let's go back. There are two kinds of vector products. So we have the scalar product, which is also known as the dot product. Okay, why do you think it's called the dot product? Because we are using a dot as our mathematical symbol. Then we go to vector product. So medyo redundant siya sa ano dito, title. Also known as cross product. Because again, we use cross for our symbol. But in this video, I'll be focusing more on scalar product. Okay. So in symbol, if you see two vectors, and then there's an operator that is a dot, then it means that you are to get the dot product of vectors A and vector B. So, si dot product or si scalar product, in the physical sense, it's simply the product of the parallel components of your two vectors. Parallel or pwede ring anti-parallel. Okay? Parallel or anti-parallel components of your vectors. Of the two vectors. So if the two vectors are perpendicular, then immediately you know that their dot product is zero. Because if the two vectors are perpendicular with each other, let's say this is vector A and this is vector B, there's no way that they'll have parallel or even anti-parallel components. So kung wala silang parallel or anti-parallel components, anong imu-multiply mo? Diba? So if two vectors are, if you're 100% sure that the two vectors are making a 90-degree angle with each other, immediately alam mo, wala silang dot product kasi nga wala ito. Okay? Ayan. So let's derive the expression of A dot B. Okay, so paano natin i-derive? We can derive that based on this definition na product siya ng parallel components ng dalawang vector. So let's try doing that. So let's say for example, we have two vectors A and B. Pag gumagawa tayo ng dot product, we use the tail-to-tail diagram. Unlike sa vector addition na nag-head to tail tayo. Okay? So in this case, A dot B, let's just say for example that my vector A goes in this direction. Hindi ko pa alam kung anong specific magnitude and direction ha, kasi mag-derive pa lang man taong definition ani. Let's call this vector A, and then kunyari meron si vector B somewhere here. It has larger magnitude but less steep yung direction niya. Let's call this vector B. Ito, si vector B. And then, the angle between the two tails, let's call this as angle phi. This is a very important and tricky part pag nakalimutan mo yung definition ni phi. So, si angle phi, ito po yung angle between the tails, ha? Pag nag-tail to tail diagram ka, immediately kukunin mo yung angle between the tails of the two vectors. Yan yung i-equivalent mo kay phi. Now, How do we show ngayon the parallel components para alam natin ano ang imumultiply? Let's take a look at vector A. So, para mapakita natin yung components ni A na parallel or perpendicular kay B, we will use vector B as our reference muna. So, si A ngayon, since ito naman yung angle with respect to B, we can make a right triangle to show its components with respect to B. Okay? Hindi yung usual na XY plane natin na ganyan, kundi it's with respect to the other vector. Siya yung gagawin mong reference. So from the tail of A, broken line tayo to show our components. This broken line that is parallel to B, obviously this is AX component. Tama ba? I hope you agree. Then, kung i-head to tail natin from the head of AX, i-draw na naman natin yung other component niya. Let's call this one as AY. So, 90 degrees ito si A at si X ha. So, parang ginawa natin na X-axis si B, tapos yung 90 degrees sa kanya, yun yung Y. Okay? Ni-rotate natin yung axis natin. Now, so in this case, it's clear now, I hope you see, that the long green line, which is vector B, is parallel to this blue broken line. So you now have the components of A and B that are parallel. So meaning to say, A dot B, you already have here, so we have... this is actually the magnitude, no? Kasi wala namang direction pag scalar product. So, ito ngayon, yung magnitude ni AX, imumultiply mo sa parallel ni B. Bakit? Because our drawing here shows that vector AX, yung AX component, is parallel to B. So, kung imultiply mo sila, makukuha mo si dot product. Kasi yun naman yung definition niya. Okay? Let's further simplify this. How do we get AX in terms of A and phi? So if you notice, meron kang right triangle na medyo tabingi. Diba? Murag ana siya. Naadiri imong AY, naadiri imong AX, naadiri imong phi, kani imong A. So si AX therefore is just A cosine phi. Kasi adjacent siya kay phi. So A is the hypotenuse times the cosine of the angle, and then you still have your B here. So if we rearrange, you have the magnitude of A, ito, absolute value nito, times the magnitude of B, ito, absolute value nito, times the cosine of the angle between them. This is now the definition of the dot product of any two vectors. Okay? Kaya naging AB cosine phi. Okay? You see this in the textbook. This is the definition of A dot B. Now, what if i-sketch naman natin ngayon yung component ni B na parallel kay A? So, in that case, we will make this time A as our reference. So, parang ito na naman yung reference natin. So, si B ngayon will become this hypotenuse. Let me erase this for a while. Yan. So, si B dito sa tail, I'll make a broken line along A kasi siya yung reference natin. So, I'll stop somewhere here. And if I use A as siya na ngayon si x-axis, then itong green na broken line, this is now our x component of B. And then from the head of BX, ito ngayon si, this is 9, I'm sorry. Taasan natin konti. Ito pala si BX, ito yung arrowhead niya. This is now BY and this is 90 degrees perpendicular to A. So you see here that this long green broken line is BX. And this short, bold line na blue is A. Pareho sila ng direction. Si A papunta dito. Si BX papunta dito. So obvious masyado na parallel sila. So we can multiply BX at saka si A. Kasi nga, parallel sila. And this will still give us A dot B. So, kung titingnan mo ulit dito, si B natin is parang naka-upside down na right triangle. Parang ganyan. Something like that. Ito yung hypotenuse. Ay, tama ba? Parang hindi. Sorry. So, right triangle yan. Ay, sorry guys. Ayan. Okay. So, ito si B. Ito si BY. Ito si BX. Ito si theta. I mean si phi. So, si BX is still adjacent to phi. BX, therefore, is just B, the hypotenuse, cosine phi. So, ang papalit natin kay BX is B cosine phi. Don't forget the magnitude of A. If you rearrange this, it's still A B cosine phi, which is again the definition of A dot B. Yan. Okay? So that is why, that's how we have this definition of A dot B. And I hope you've read from the textbook or any other materials na si scalar product, it's called scalar product because it's like ang parents niya vectors, si A at saka B si vector, pero ang offspring, ang anak, scalar. So whatever is the answer here, this no longer has a direction, it only has magnitude. Kasi nga, scalar quantity siya. Okay? So, in module 3, we will have a very specific application of the dot product, which is the concept of work. So we will learn later that work is actually the dot product of the applied force and displacement. So ito siya ngayon ang application niyan. Force is a vector quantity, displacement is vector quantity, pero yung resulta, yung work, is a scalar. Ayan. Okay? So, in determining the value of A dot B, ang final answer ninyo, wala ng direction. Wala ng I hat, J hat, K hat, ha? Kasi nga, scalar na siya. So, ano pa ba? What else? So, if we say, therefore, kung mag-unit vector tayo, we say that I dot I equals J hat pala, dot J equals K dot K hat. These are all equal to 1. Tama ba? Unit vectors? Are you agree? Tingnan natin. Kung I hat dot I hat, ito na bali si A, ito si B. Diba? So, paano nga yon? Magnitude ni A, anong magnitude ni I hat? Diba 1? Anong magnitude ni J hat? 1 din. Anong angle between them? So, si I hat papuntang positive x, another I hat papuntang positive x. Kung i-tail to tail mo siya, the angle between them is 0 degree. So, cosine of 0 is of course positive 1. Kaya, ang answer dito, 1. No? Because they are going in the same direction. Tama ba? What if it's I hat dot negative J hat. I'm sorry. I hat negative I hat. Paano yan? Okay. So, itong si positive I hat papuntang right. Tail to tail mo siya sa kabila na negative I hat. What's the angle between them if you make a straight line? Diba? This is 180 degrees. So, this becomes magnitude of the first vector is just 1. Magnitude of the second vector is also 1. And then you have the cosine of the angle between them. Cosine 180 is negative 1. So the answer here is negative 1. Okay? What if you have J hat dot K hat? Ano yan? Si J papunta dito. I'm sorry, sa taas. So if we have our Cartesian plane as the usual, this is X, Y, Z. So, ito siya, positive J hat, paakyat, tail to tail with positive K hat, dito. This makes a 90 degree angle. So the angle between them is 90 degrees. So J dot K becomes, this is magnitude 1 times 1 cosine 90. What's the cosine of 90? Correct, 0. So this, and the answer here is 0. Why? Sabi ko kanina, if the two vectors are perpendicular, then there's no way in the world that they'll have component na parallel. So anong imumultiply mo kung walang parallel? Kaya 0 talaga yan. Okay? Yan. So please try solving problems on scalar product. If there are any unclear parts in the book while you study, we can discuss it during our online conferences. Okay? Stay well. God bless you. Until the next video.